Hello friends, last time we have explained about the structure of plasma membrane or cell membrane. We know the cell membrane or the plasma membrane is the outermost protective covering of the cells, which gives particular shape and size to the cells and encloses the various cellular components inside in the form of cytoplasm, cytoplasmic organelles, cytoplasmic matrix, or the nucleus and the nucleoplasm. So all type of cells requires nutrients, oxygen, or certain other materials which are essential for the cellular metabolism or different life processes or various biological reactions which are taking place in the cells are under the influence of different type of substances which are passing through the plasma membrane. There is a two-way transport of the substances or the materials which are essential for the cellular metabolism or different activities of the cells, such as nutrients, oxygen, water, minerals, vitamins, enzymes. So there are large number of materials or the substances which are essential for the different life processes or the activities of the cells, and thus which should be transported or which should be provided or supplied to the cell cytoplasm so that cell can function its biological function normally. So different type of nutrients, minerals, vitamins, ions, enzymes, oxygen, water. So there are different materials or the substances which are essential for the growth, development, or the establishment of the cells. And similarly, whatever the end product or the waste products produced in the cell, such as nitrogenous waste, carbon dioxide, and so on, this should be removed from the cell. So there needs the two-way transportation of the substances, either which are essential to the cell or the materials which are not required in the cell or which are waste products in the cell or harmful to the cell. This should be eliminated from the cells. So this type of transportation, that is the supply of the various materials and removal of the various materials from the cell, will occur through the plasma membrane, indicating that the cell membranes or the plasma membranes are permeable or semi-permeable, and thus they function for the transport of different biomolecules or the different biological compounds through the plasma membrane. So this transport of the substances through the plasma membrane, which is essential for the cell cells or different type of cells in the living organism, that is all plants, animals, or the microorganisms which are composed of different type of cells and having the cell membrane or the plasma membrane, or they needs a different type of cellular metabolism or the biochemical reactions in the cells so as to carry out different functions of the living organism. So the plasma membrane is very important to transport or to supply the materials to the cells or to remove the unwanted substances from the cells. And both these activities, that is import or export or transport of materials into the cell or to the outside of the cell, occur through the plasma membrane. So the main function of the plasma membrane is to regulate the flow of materials in and out of the cell, is called as a transport. And this transport of the material is regulated by the size of the pores present in the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is a semi-permeable membrane which allows the passage of solvent but not all the solutes. Means there is a selective transportation or selective permeability or selective permission to the substances to pass through the plasma membrane. So, plasma membrane is a semi-permeable membrane and which allows the passage of solvent or different substances selectively. So, there is a selective permeability or plasma membrane allows, while plasma membrane thus allows the selective permeability or the selective substances to pass through it, representing the semi-permeability of the plasma membrane. And this may happens through the pores of the variable size. Variable size of the pores, variable size of the pores or the different size of pores are present along the plasma membrane and thus which are allowing the biological compounds with a definite size or definite range of the size of the materials. The plasma membrane which permits one substance to pass through more easily than another is called as a selective permeable. Transport of the metabolites or the various substances or the biological compounds through the plasma membrane takes place by four different types that can be divided into passive transport or the active transport. So, passive transport includes simple diffusion and facilitated type of diffusion. So, these are the two type of passive transport of the substances or the materials. So, this happens freely, the passive transport of the molecules or the biomolecules or the biological compounds or the substances occurs through the plasma membrane. It is a simple type of diffusion and it occurs through the pores of the different size are, which are present on the plasma membrane or in the plasma membrane. And this type of transport, passive transport, that is a simple diffusion, that is the transport of biological compounds or the substances from higher concentration to the outside and lower concentration to the inside. So, this type of process of the transport is called as simple diffusion and it simply occurs through the different type of pores which are present in the plasma membrane. So, different substances which pass through directly or freely through the variable pore size of the plasma membrane from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. This may be outside to inside or inside to outside of the plasma membrane, or this may be happening or occurring from outside to inside or inside to outside of the cell. So, the transport of the substances, the transport of the substances or the materials through the plasma membrane occurs by means of simple diffusion, that is the transport of biological compounds or the substances from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. This may be from outside to inside of the cell or from inside of the cell to the outside of the cell through the plasma membrane is called as simple diffusion. Then another mode is facilitated diffusion. This type of diffusion of the materials occurs through the plasma membrane, but this requires some sort of materials, may be carriers or the channels. So, there may be a transport of biological compounds or the substances occurring through the channels or the channel proteins. So, which will again allow the certain substances to pass through the plasma membrane consisting of a channel proteins or the channels. And these channels also facilitates or perform the process of transport of the substances from higher concentration to the lower concentration. Then there are certain carrier proteins which are also present on the surface of plasma membrane, which binds with the various substances from the outside of the cell and carries them to the inside by means of the carrier complexes. So substance carrier complex, substance and the carrier complex is thus formed to the outside of the cells, causing the binding of the various substances to the carrier proteins, and which will then pass or transport these materials along with the carrier complex, substance carrier complex, into the cells. So this is also the transport of molecules or the substances from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration, either from outside to inside or inside to outside. But this facilitates, means there are a sort of facilities, there are sort of facilities or the provision for the transport of substances with the help of either channels or the carrier proteins, and such type of transport of the substances is called as facilitated diffusion. So diffusion is thus a process of passage or the transport of the substances from the region of higher concentration to lower concentration, and this does not require any energy or ATP is not required. There is no need of the spending energy for such a transportation. So first we'll explain the passive transport with two type of passive transport methods, such as simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion. The simplest way for a solute or a substance to move from one side of the membrane to the other is a simple diffusion. So simplest way for the transport or passage of the solute or the substances to move from one side of the plasma membrane to the other side along the concentration means from a region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration, and it is the unassisted net movement. Unassisted means without any help of other substance, without any facility, without any support or without any help, there is a transportation of the molecules from one side to the other side through the plasma membrane. So it is unassisted net movement of the solute from a region of the higher concentration to the region of lower concentration, and concentration gradient disappears, and the concentration gradient disappears as diffusion occurs. There is no stereospecificity. There is no stereospecificity, and the process is slow. So the simple diffusion is thus a slow process, and there is no stereospecificity, and also ATP or energy is not utilized. So there is no need of energy for the process of simple diffusion. So this is a simple slow process of transportation of the biological compounds from one side of the cell to the other side of the cell. One side of the cell, that is inside to outside or outside to inside, through the plasma membrane or through the pores of the different sides. So this is a quite simple process of passage or the transportation of the biological compounds through the plasma membrane without help of any other substance or any other biochemical, just like carrier proteins or the channel proteins. Such type of facilities are not essential in the process of simple diffusion. So simple diffusion occurs through just the pores or the variable pore size present in the plasma membrane. So that will allow the passage of molecules or the biological compounds or the substances through the pores of the definite size or the solutes of the definite size from one side of the membrane to the other side is called as simple diffusion, and this happens usually from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. Then second type, that is facilitated diffusion. In this type of diffusion, energy is not required. This type of diffusion, that is facilitated type of diffusion, also does not require any energy. It takes place along the concentration gradient, similar to the simple diffusion, that is the transport of molecules or the substances from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration, may be outside to inside or inside to outside, but does not require any energy or the ATP. However, it differs from simple diffusion in some respect, that is, it requires carriers. That is, it requires carriers for the transport of the metabolite across the membrane. And secondly, it is a stereospecific process. It is a stereospecific process, that is, only one isomer or the only one substance is transported at a time. So these are the two criterions or the two conditions. These are the two conditions which are occurring in the facilitated diffusion, while the transport of the metabolites or the substances across the membrane. One thing that it is it needs the carriers. It needs the carriers. Maybe the carrier proteins or the enzymes which are carrying the certain substances along with a particular complex, that is the carrier substance metabolite and metabolite carrier complex is formed at the outer surface of the plasma membrane. So there is a formation of carrier metabolite or a material complex, carrier metabolite complex, and that carries that complex or that carrier carries the particular substance from outside the cell into the cytoplasm of the cells with the help of carriers or carrier protein. And another thing, that is, it is a stereospecific process. Stereospecific process means there are different type of carriers. Means there are different type of carriers which can recognize or which can have a definite binding site, definite binding site. So that will thus get bind or the attachment to the metabolite which is having somewhat the coincidence for the attachment of the metabolite and the carrier. So carriers, there are different type of carriers which might have different functional groups, which might have different functional groups with the help of which they can bind with a particular substance or the metabolite to form metabolite carrier complex, and then can carry the particular substance inside of the cells. So it is a stereospecific process. That is, only one isomer is transported. So only one substance or the metabolite with a specific size or with a specific functional group to which the particular carrier protein get attached to form the carrier metabolite complex, and then only can carry the particular substance to pass through the plasma membrane. This also not requiring any energy. This is also a type of diffusion, that is the transport of the biomolecules from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. But this is assisted. This is a assisted type of movement of the solute from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration with the help of either channels or the carrier proteins. So there may be a channel with a composed of a channel of proteins, and that will allow the particular solute with a definite size to pass through the channel proteins, or there may be the certain type of carriers and which will bind with the certain metabolite with the consideration of its size or its charge or its functional group, and bind with the particular substance, and then can facilitate its transport from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration, that is from outside to cell to the inside of the cell, or might be from inside to the outside of the cell with the help of the carrier proteins or the channel proteins. Such type of diffusion is called as a facilitated type of diffusion. Facilitated diffusion, this also does not require any energy or the ATP for the transport of these biological materials or the substances. Now, this is the figure representing, or which with the help of which we can explain the process of passive transport and its two types, that is simple diffusion and the facilitated diffusion. So, in a simple diffusion, in the first diagram, in a diagram A, we have captions of these three diagrams to explain simple diffusion and facilitated diffusion, having three diagrams A, B and C. So, in first diagram, having a caption, that is A diagram, simple diffusion of the non-polar molecules through the phospholipid bilayer. So, this is a quite simple process of diffusion or the transport or the passage of the non-polar molecules. So, these are the substances or the biological compounds without any charge, non-polar molecules without any charge, and which are present in the extracellular fluid or the extracellular space or the fluid present outside the cell. So, these substances, non-polar molecules, as shown in the diagram A, we can see the spherical structures with a dark yellow color or the brownish color, having different size, which are passing through the plasma membrane directly through the different sized pores. So, there are simple pores or the perforations present in the plasma membrane through which different substances passing inside of the cells. Similarly, the substances can also pass to the outside. So, there is a two-way transport. There is a two-way transport, that is outside to inside and inside to outside, along the concentration gradient. Along the concentration gradient means the transport of non-polar molecules from the extracellular fluid inside the cytoplasm of the cells through the phospholipid bilayer of the plasma membrane from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. So, concentration of these substances is more to the outside in the extracellular fluid, so which will pass inside of the cell where there is a lower concentration of the same substance or the same solute. Then, in the same diagram, we can see the transport of some non-polar molecules from cytoplasm to the extracellular fluid, that is dark pink colored molecules which are present, spherical molecules which are present with a variable size in the cytoplasm, and that will pass out to the outside into the extracellular fluid from the region of higher concentration in the cytoplasm to the lower concentration region to the outside. So, in a diagram A, we can get clear idea about the passage or the transport of non-polar molecules or the solute or the biological compounds with the variable size, which directly pass through the pores present in the plasma membrane with a variable size from the region of higher concentration to lower concentration, that is from outside to inside or inside to the outside of the cell. Then, in a middle diagram, which represents an example of facilitated diffusion. So, in a diagram B, where there is a transport of ions or the charged particles or the charged substances or the solute, which are again passing from the region of higher concentration, that is the green colored molecules with a plus sign. These green colored circles, you can see the ions, green colored spherical molecules of the ions or the various substances which are with a higher concentration in an extracellular fluid or to the outside of the cell, and the plasma membrane possessing the channels. So, there are intrinsic proteins or the channel proteins which are having a particular size of the particular sized channels through which these ions pass from the outside to the inside of the cells, passing through the channel proteins or the channels of the plasma membrane, which are shown in the green color. So, green colored channels, which allows the passage of ions or the ionic metabolites or ionic solute or the substances from the outside of the cell, from the extracellular fluid into the cell through the channel from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration, that is from outside to inside. Then in the same diagram, facilitated diffusion of the ions through a channel, that is again from the cytoplasm to the extracellular fluid or to the outside of the cell through the plasma membrane. This also happens with the help of channels with a brown color or the orange color channel. So, the ions are again passing through the brown colored channels, and the substances or the metabolites or the ionic compounds, biological compounds or the metabolites or the substances with a higher concentration in the cytoplasm will pass outside into the extracellular fluid, where there is a lower lower concentration of the same substances. So, the middle diagram or the diagram B represents the facilitated diffusion of the ions through a channel. This will also not require any energy. So, this is the diagram showing diagrams A, B and C representing simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion of the ions through the channels, and the facilitated diffusion of the polar and the ionic molecules using a carrier. So, in third diagram, diagram C represents the two type of carrier proteins with a blue color and the gray color, violet color. So, this also represents the transport of molecules from the region of higher concentration, that is extracellular fluid or the from the outside of the cell to the into the cytoplasm of the cell. So, these are the carrier proteins having the capacity to pass or to carry the polar molecules or the ionic molecules with a definite size through the particular carrier present in the plasma membrane. So, facilitated diffusion of the polar and ionic molecules, which are using the carrier for their passage or the transportation from the region of higher concentration to the outside to the region of lower concentration in the cytoplasm. Similarly, on the other side, that is on the right side, there is another carrier with a violet color, and the substances, that is polar or ionic molecules, which are present inside the cytoplasm with a higher concentration can be carried to the outside by using the carriers to the outside, that is again for from the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. So, this is a passive transport. This is a type of passive transport, that is a simple diffusion and the facilitated diffusion. So, A diagram डायग्राम ए रिप्रेजेंटिंग सिंपल डिफ्यूजन ऑफ द नॉन पोलर मॉलिक्यूल्स थ्रू द फॉस्फोलिपिड बायलेयर थ्रू द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पोर्स डायरेक्ट सिंपल पासेज ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स नॉन पोलर बायो मॉलिक्यूल्स फ्रॉम हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन थ्रू द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन एंड नो एनर्जी और एटीपी इज यूटिलाइज फॉर दिस टाइप ऑफ डिफ्यूजन. देन फैसिलिटेटेड डिफ्यूजन दैट इज डायग्राम बी रिप्रेजेंट्स द पासेज ऑफ आयन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ चैनल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो द ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ आयन्स फ्रॉम द रीजन ऑफ हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. दिस इज ऑल्सो टू वे दैट इज आउटसाइड टू इनसाइड एंड इनसाइड टू आउटसाइड. दिस इज ऑल्सो रिप्रेजेंटिंग टू वे ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ द और द सब्सटेंसेस और द आयन्स फ्रॉम हायर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टू लोअर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन यूजिंग द चैनल्स ऑफ द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. Then thirdly, the C in a diagram C, which is representing facilitated diffusion of the polar and ionic molecules using the carriers, which are also present in the plasma membrane, and the transport of which also occurring from the region of higher concentration to lower concentration, either from outside to inside or to inside or inside to outside of the cell through the plasma membrane. So in all the three diagrams, we can see there is a passive transport of the substances, either non-polar molecules or the polar molecules or the ions, using the channels, carriers, or the simple pores which are present in the plasma membrane. And transport of molecules occurs from higher concentration to the lower concentration without the use or the utilization of any energy or the ATP. The role of carrier protein is simply to facilitate the diffusion of the polar or charged solute. The role of carrier protein in a previous diagram, as we have explained in a third diagram, diagram C, that is a carrier protein. The role of carrier protein is simply to facilitate the diffusion of the polar or charged solute. Carriers are the proteins with a relatively low molecular weight. Carriers are the proteins with a relatively low molecular weight, that is ranging from 9 to 40,000, and are present in the phospholipid layer of the plasma membrane, but they are highly selective. The metabolite binds the metabolites or the substances with a variable size or the charge, maybe a positive charge or the negative charge metabolite, which binds to the carrier protein at the outer surface of the membrane to form a carrier metabolite complex. So at the time of transport of the polar molecules or the charged solute, they get bind with the carrier proteins to form a carrier metabolite complex, and then this diffuses along the concentration gradient, that is from higher from the region of higher concentration to the region of low concentration in the cells. The metabolite is then released towards the inner surface of the membrane. The metabolite or the substances are then released towards the inner surface of the membrane as there is a low concentration of the metabolite on the inner side. It is continued as long as concentration gradient is developed. It is continued as long as a concentration gradient is developed. The transport of glucose into the erythrocytes, the transport of the glucose into the erythrocytes or RBCs is a good example of the facilitated diffusion. The transport of the glucose molecule into the erythrocytes or the RBCs is a good example of the facilitated diffusion. So this is about the passive transport of the solute or the various substances or the various metabolites or the biological compounds which are essential in the cell, and thus are transported from outside to inside or the region of higher concentration to the lower concentration, that is from outside to inside into cytoplasm of the cells. Similarly, the certain metabolites or the solutes or the substances which are formed in the cytoplasm of cells and which are now unwanted, which might be the end products, which might be the end products of the metabolism of the cell, and now these are unwanted substances or might be harmful to the cell itself, and thus which can be carried or transported to the outside by this method, that is where inside of the cytoplasm the concentration of which will get increased ultimately, which will again pass through the plasma membrane to the outside, that is from region of the higher concentration to the lower concentration to the outside of the cells. So there may be the transport of the biological compounds or the substances from inside to outside or outside to inside of the cells along the concentration gradient, and the transport of the molecules will occur from higher concentration to their lower concentration through the plasma membrane, either through the simple pores with a particular size which is present in the plasma membrane, or with the use of the channels which are also present in the form of channel proteins in the phospholipid layer of the plasma membrane, which will also allow the passage of molecules, that is ions, with the help of channel proteins with a specific size, or even the facilitated diffusion, that is with the help of carrier proteins, which are also having its functional group or the active site or the active group to which the metabolite get attached or get bind to form a carrier metabolite complex to the outside of the cell on the surface of the plasma membrane. So carrier protein, which is having its functional group or the active site or the binding site to which the particular metabolite or the substance with a charge, that is either polar molecules or the charged molecules or the solute, get attached to the carrier protein and which are then carried into the inside of the cell through the plasma membrane with the help of carrier proteins, and which are then released inside of the cytoplasm where there is a low concentration of the particular substance. So this is what about the passive transport and the two type of passive transport, that is simple diffusion, and second, that is a facilitated diffusion with the two types, that is with the help of channel proteins and with the help of carrier proteins, but facilitating the transport of the biological compounds, two-way transportation of the biological compounds through the plasma membrane with either use of channel proteins or the carrier proteins, and this does not require any energy and thus is called as a passive transport. So today with this we'll stop here. Next time we'll explain the second or the next type of transport, that is active transport. Thank you.